Today's video, I'm going to show you the return of Counter-Strike, or at least a version of Counter-Strike that I think is actually really, really effective. And we're going to be doing this out of the Gun Bunch offset formation in the Indianapolis Colts offensive playbook. Now, if you want to get my entire Colts offensive ebook, make sure that you join the Patreon. We're going to be talking about double posts today, primarily talking about the C route. But the Patreon's only $10, and it gets you access to all of my offensive and defensive ebooks. So if you want to become a member today, like I said, it's only $10 to sign up. The link's in the description. You get access to everything, as well as all of the updated ebooks when they are released. What we're going to show you today is a left side flood concept. It's actually really, really effective. So what we're going to do is we're going to streak our slot receiver. We are going to streak our running back, and we're going to drag our tight end. So you see, this is what the route combination is going to look like. And essentially what we have here is we have a high low on the left hand side. Now what we're kind of building around with this setup is we're building around this C route on the left hand side, one of the most versatile routes in the entire game. And as you can see, essentially we have a high low between the C route on the left and the tight end drag. Now if it is man coverage, sometimes that C route will get covered, and sometimes the C route will get open. You've got to just look over there. A lot of times, even if the C route does get covered, you can aggressive catch it against man coverage, especially if you have gift wrap. Gift wrap will significantly help you to be able to be a little bit more consistent. But one of the most common adjustments we see from people in Madden 24 is this outside third on the solo wide receiver on the bunch side. What you're going to see is by motioning this running back streak to the outside, the C route is going to get wide open, and you are going to be able to absolutely obliterate that coverage. And so they're going to have to get out of that. They're going to have to do a couple different things. One of the things that we're going to be able to also attack is another meta that's up and coming, and that's the cover four drop. You're going to see here that outside quarter will suck to that running back, and the C route's going to be wide open on the sideline. This is provided that you are running this with your running back to the short side of the field. If you're running back to the wide side of the field, it's a little bit more tight of a throw. Now, what about a basic standard cover three? Well, if you watch what the curl flat defender is going to do, he is going to oftentimes actually match and potentially be able to take away your C route. The problem is there is obviously a lot of vulnerabilities in terms of what he's not going to cover. So there's two openings here that he's not going to cover. The first one is this actual quick seam to the running back into the middle, into the interior of the passing lane. You can look to that as well. Sometimes he will reroute him. It kind of depends on what your opponent's doing from a coaching adjustments perspective. But if you see that curl flat defender over there, go ahead and throw it to your tight end and just turn up field. As you can see there, we've got about 15 to 20 yards just with a simple check down. That's the whole purpose of that tight end drag, is if they're not playing hard flats, then the tight end drag is going to be wide open. Now, if they are playing hard flats, your C route is going to get open over the top of that, which I got crazy shedded there. So let me show you that in another rep here. And then you might think, well, what if they try to use the left side, or what if they try to over adjust? That's actually crazy. I just got shedded again. Wow. All right. So there you go. I have the best blitz in the game out of the 3-3 formation. All you got to do is just use the D line. That's actually crazy. Anyways, so you might think, well, okay, so what do I do in a situation of like they're going to use your left-hand side? This is why we're doing this out of the play double post, because the play double post has the best post route in the entire game in the middle of the field here. So let's say, for example, that their user decides, hey, I'm going to go user this route over here on the left-hand side. If he decides that he's going to go user on the left-hand side, your streak post concept here on the back, this streak's going to clear out the third. This guy's going to come underneath it, and you can possession catch that for a pretty big gain against the defense. So they're going to have to stay in the middle of the field to defend that. And so really what we're walking them into is they're going to have to be in some type of cover two. The problem is most people don't want to be in cover two to the left because there's a lot of vulnerabilities. We'll get to that in a minute. But what you'll see here is if they are pressed up, you can still typically hit this C route. The one thing is you can see there, if you have a super tall corner over there, like a 6'4", a lot of times that cloud will actually get back. So what you might want to do if you have the ability to is put him on a hot route master C route. The hot route master C route will get just a little bit more down the field, and it will be a little bit more open against a standard cover two cloud. But what a lot of people are going to do And what we're going to force them to basically do with this is we're going to force them into a defense that looks basically something like this, your traditional double Mabel. Now, again, remember, they've got to use the post route in the middle of the field. That's their job. They have to take that post route in the middle of the field. So because they have to take that post route in the middle of the field, it's going to open up the seams for the running back. So you'll see here, I could pass like this inside, potentially try to click on, make a catch, or it's going to open up some other plays as well in my playbook. But the main thing that we wanted to show you today is just how versatile this running or this this motion out running back streak is, when the, and it's going to force them into certain coverages that are going to put them at a pretty significant disadvantage in terms of how they're going to be able to defend everything else that you can do offensively out of this formation. So I want to thank you guys for watching the video. If you want to take your Madden game to the next level, I'd really encourage you to join the Patreon. If you haven't already, it's only $10. You can sign up by heading down to the description and clicking the link down below.